Hey everyone, it's Glem3.
And LlamaGal300.
And welcome back to Phoenix Wright. We're on our last day of our final trial. Let's go. We're going to do some investigating.
Kind of final trial.
Yeah.
That's complicated.
There's technically an extra trial that was released for the DS version originally.
Yeah.
But it's not. That's not really
mind-bending if you don't play it. It actually, I think the game itself makes more sense if you don't play it, but
hey,
that's
pal.
A solid case.
Long time no see.
Oh, Detective Gumshoe.
Close one today. I'm Canadian. I got so worked up I snapped my tie in half. Sorry about that. No prob, pal. Thanks to you, we now know who really did it.
You mean the boat shop caretaker.
Look, I'll make you a promise. I'll have that scoundrel in my custody by trial time tomorrow. Come what may. It's my duty to see to you as a police officer. Now I'm off to catch me a criminal.
Doom, 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 doom.
Adios, Gumshoe.
Detective Gumshoe sure is active today.
Oh, one other thing.
Eek!
No one can go into the woods today.
The woods?
Where Lotta was camping. That was like a weird question, though. The woods are off limits to camping, and apparently the park ranger found out. He got pretty mad. No one can go in for a while.
I guess Lotta's in a lot of, oh god, they're making a pun out of her name, which is already a pun.
Like, her name is already a pun?
I mean, I
half love them, and I'm also angry.
Angry. I must have my vengeance.
This whole part is just really bad puns. Anyway, I'll be seeing you tomorrow. Or should I say three-morrow? Because it's the third day.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just as funny as them. Okay. Gored Lake Public Beach.
I guess you could say the bullet gored the victim.
This place is a real beach to play through. Huh? The steel eyesore is missing. Now they're making puns. We're making puns.
Eyesore?
All terrible. Looks like the hot dog stand is closed, too.
Well, because Larry's at your office. I guess Larry. I was like, that was like me, like, substituting something in for Maya's line.
Oh, I gotcha. Okay. He's not gonna be at the boat rental shop. Oh, but there's something here, apparently.
No, they always do that when we, like, haven't been somewhere on that day yet. That old caretaker got away.
But there's always dialogue.
Mm.
Yep.
I never imagined he might be the real murderer.
Ahem! What? I know that clearing of the throat anywhere. Larry Bucks!
Aha, hello. What might you be doing here? Out for a walk, hmm? Ah, the days of my youth like the scent of fresh lemon.
Again.
You see.
Mr. Grossberg, this is no time for idle reminiscing. Mr. Edgeworth's trial ends tomorrow.
Ooh, that is true, yes. But from what I saw of today's trial, Edgeworth should be fine, right?
Well, I'm not so sure about that.
Ho ho ho! Ha cha 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 cha!
Ah cha cha cha!
What do you mean by that?
Well, I'm not sure. They're like reacting to what we just said.
If you've got anything out, come by my office at once. I may be able to offer you some assistance. Goodbye.
Thanks. Bye.
What do you think of Mr. Grossberg? What do you think Mr. Grossberg was doing here anyway?
Who knows?
Do you go into the shop?
What?
Oh,
we can.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
And you have to.
We can open the safe now.
Yeah. Nobody's home. Hello. Oh, that's you.
Hello, squawk.
Hey, it's Polly. I wonder where your owner's gone, Polly.
Hello, squawk.
I can't believe he'd run off and leave his poor parrot to fend for herself.
Hello, squawk.
God.
That's terrible.
Okay. We say that about everything in this. That's terrible.
That's horrifying.
That's atrocious.
That reminds me, Nick. Polly here knows the number to the safe, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Polly, what's the safe number?
12288.
It's Von Karma.
That would be the best plot twist. He just like rips off, like he takes the wing, and he's like, and he's Von Karma.
Master of disguise, baby.
That's so not funny, but we're laughing so much. It actually is hilarious. Just like, oh, okay.
Let's open it, Nick. Come on.
I'm pretty sure there isn't any money in there.
Aw, man. But hey, he keeps it locked, right?
Larceny,
so there must
hilarious.
Be something of value in there.
I'm not so sure.
Okay, Nick, let's see what's in there.
I guess there might be a clue or two. The only thing in here is a letter.
A letter? Aw,
like,
boring.
I thought this is literally the best like possible piece of evidence we could get.
I know.
I mean, there's no name or signature on this thing. It's handwritten in very precise, clear letters. Get your revenge on Miles Edgeworth?
Edgeworth! Oh, that's you, sorry. I freaked out. Nick, why would Mr. Edgeworth's name be on here?
How should I know? I'm going to read the whole thing. Get your revenge on Miles Edgeworth. He also says this is your last chance. Now is your time to get revenge on the two men who ruined your life. The rest of the letter goes on to describe the murder plot in detail. How to kill Robert Hammond and frame Roger Edgeworth.
Roger Edgeworth?
What did I just read? What did he actually say?
How to frame Roger Hammond and
Roger Hammond
Edgeworth.
And Edgeworth. I don't know why I read it like that. Calling Edgeworth out to the lake, getting on the boat, firing twice. Like I said, like if you read
if you read a lot,
like over the period of a day, you like stop
being able to read. Or write, if you write a lot. Like when you write an essay on the last minute and then you forget how to write.
This is exactly what I figured out today. It's like only for those of you who have taken the PSATs, the SATs,
yeah,
the grammar section.
Oh my god! And then you're like, I don't like having been in that.
Yeah, it makes sense for like the first like 10. Or
yeah, or
and then it starts like just sounding weird whenever you read anything. Anyway, that's completely irrelevant.
Yes. What do you think it means, Nick?
I don't know, but it looks like these are instructions for that caretaker. When he killed Robert Hammond and called out Edgeworth, he was following instructions.
That's not really something you should really leave out there on top of your TV.
No, also, I was thinking though, when I saw this, I thought it was just like a letter that he wrote to himself, because he has a bad memory,
that's true.
So when do you think that,
that's true, I don't know. But, yeah, I guess, I don't know. But who could have written that letter? And what does it mean to get revenge on Miles Edgeworth?
Look, I don't know, okay? He seems angry. But one thing's for certain. This letter is an amazing clue. Yep. So, now where should we get? Where should we head to?
Let's see.
Can we go to the precinct?
Yeah, I was about to say, can we go to the precinct already?
If so, then this is really short.
Yeah.
I kind of remember this day of investigation being shorter than the others, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we've been filming for 7 minutes, so I guess that's a short.
Number 27, police department. Dun-dun.
Yeah, I know. It does look like the Law and Order area.
Looks like Detective Gumshoe hasn't gotten back yet. Gumshoe, he won't be coming back today.
Oh, really?
He said there was some guy he had to arrest by tomorrow. The boat shop caretaker. He shouted something about catching you if it's the last thing I do, pal. Good luck, Gumshoe. Huh?
I guess we can't go into the records room yet. Maybe we have to go see Edgeworth and talk to him about, like, his nightmare? Yeah, we have to go talk to Edgeworth about his nightmare.
Oh, right. We forgot to do that. Let's go do that. This is by far my favorite case, I just gotta say. It's just so much fun to play through.
Yeah, it's my favorite case from this game.
And, like, literally just, like, all the amazing plot twists in this. You look as grim as always.
Mr. Edgeworth, I heard the story about the class trial. Class trial? What do you mean? You don't remember? No, I don't. Your lunch money was stolen, wasn't it, in fourth grade? How did you know? Lunch had scarred me for the rest of my life.
That was the DL6 incident. Imagine if that was the DL6 incident. This lunch money being stolen.
I should call it that.
There's just like a children's version of this game. Just like
that'd
with
be
them
so
all kids.
Cute.
That'd be so cool. Stupid.
Oh, right. Yes, I seem to remember something like that.
That actually would be neat if you played like an old trial that they acted out as kids.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Nick, I think you're the only one who really remembers.
Well, it probably really only mattered to me anyway.
Mr. Edgeworth, didn't you know? That trial was the reason Nick became a defense attorney. He came to find you, because he's obsessed with you and in love with you. Ridiculous!
Gee, thanks.
Bogarts are gone. That said, it does sound like the kind of thing you do. You haven't changed a bit, have you, Wright? So simple, to a fault, even.
Well, maybe, yeah, but I think you changed too much, Edgeworth.
Perhaps. Perhaps. Governor?
Governor? Pop it?
Why prosecute?
Hey, Edgeworth. Why did you become a prosecutor anyway? You used to look up to your dad. You said you wanted to be a defense attorney, right?
I couldn't let myself deny reality like you.
What do you mean?
My father was taken from me, and you want me to defend criminals? I'm sorry, Wright, but I'm not that good of a person. One suspect was apprehended in your father's murder, right? Yes. That man trapped in the elevator with my father. His name was Yanni Yogi. He had to be the shooter any way you look at it. Yet, he was found innocent. That defense attorney got him off the hook.
That would be Robert Hammond.
On that day, 15 years ago, the three of us were trapped in that elevator for 5 hours. When we were rescued, we all suffered oxygen deprivation. I had lost all memory of the murder.
Lost your memory?
Even now, I can't recall what happened in the elevator. Oh, Edgeworth, you joker.
what a trickster. It's like, it's just...
pranking us all the time. That was the crux of Yogi's attorney's argument in court. He claimed Yanni Yogi had been not sound of mind due to the oxygen deprivation. Yogi was released due to lack of evidence. Innocent. That's when I changed my mind.
That was a delayed phew.
I started to hate defense attorneys.
Prosecutor Von Karma, what's your relationship with him?
He's my teacher and a man who deserves respect. I learned everything I know of courtroom techniques from him. So he's like my sister was to you, Nick. Only she didn't try to get you to go to jail. He's a perfectionist in all things. In court, in his personal life. Actually, Mia helped us not go to jail, so he's obsessed with doing everything perfectly. Good boy. Good boy.
Shut up. Fixing the mic. Okay.
Perfectly, huh?
You almost did the accent.
In all the cases he's taken on, none were left unsolved. And not one suspect was declared innocent. Ever. But that's... I know. It's possible some of the suspects were indeed innocent. However, it is impossible for us to inaccurately determine that.
For us to accurately.
For us to accurately.
It's just impossible. How could we possibly inaccurately?
All Von Karma does is his job to find the suspect guilty. Perfect. That's actually is a prosecutor's job. Like, you really can't, like, not do that. In any case, it's nigh well impossible to find a weakness in him. Should a weakness appear, he would do everything in his power to make it go away.
Edgeworth? If what you're saying is true, you're headed for a guilty sentence tomorrow.
He's right! There's no time to praise the enemy, Mr. Edgeworth. It's a strange situation in which I find myself, I'll admit.
No kidding. Alright, is that everything we got?
I think we have to present the letter to him.
Oh.
And don't present that, because that's a picture of his dead father, so.
No, I think we should actually present it to Grossberg, but... This came out of the safe in the shack where that boat rental caretaker lives.
I see. Revenge? On me? Who is that old guy anyways? I don't know.
Could he be an innocent defendant? You got declared guilty or something?
Nice, right. But I don't remember that old man. Not at all. So he was following this letter then. Which means there was someone else behind it.
Now is your time to get revenge on the two men who ruined you. You're not doing it.
Oh, is that Edgeworth?
Yeah.
Oh. I'm just putting on a book. That joker, Edgeworth. Now is the time to get revenge on the two men who ruined your life. Two men, meaning myself and Robert Hammond. It also says this is your last chance. Last chance. Oh, that's a year.
Last chance. Wait, maybe. Maybe he's talking about the statute of limitations on the DL6 incident.
Wait. Wait, that old man. What is it? Do you know who he is? Yogi. Could he be Yogi? This is why you're a genius, Edgeworth. Yogi? The suspect in the DL6 incident. The one who was found innocent. I think we have a new...
Yeah, the pieces of the puzzle are starting to come together. Do you have anything else to present?
I mean, the picture of his dad and then Phoenix yells at Maya. Oh, wait, I think we have to talk to him about Yanni Yogi. Is there any conversation?
Oh, well, we'll check that in a second.
Okay. Ahem! Oh.
He's out. Again. Weird that he has... Why was there someone
There's
popping?
There's a recording.
There's a recording of an
that
ahem?
That black box on the table is like a little recording. When does he work, anyway?
That mahogany table. Now, don't be harsh. Guess we'll have to come back later. Okay, I guess you're right.
Mahogany.
So much mahogany.
Talk to him, dear. Yanni Yogi.
Oh, there, you're right.
Yanni Yogi was a court bailiff at the time. We just happened to be in that elevator together 15 years ago. The quake was incredibly strong. Before I knew it, everything was dark. We were there for so long, it felt like forever. The air thinned and the darkness closed in on us in that little box. We became unsettled. I think that's Yana Yogi.
Help! I can't breathe! Quiet, I said quiet! You're not making this any easier. I want to get out! Help! Get us out!
Don't shout! You'll just use up more oxygen. That's all I remember. When I came to, I was in a hospital bed, staring up at the ceiling. Little worthy. In court, Yana Yogi's mental condition was called into question. They claimed the oxygen deprivation and stress had caused him temporary insanity. In the end, the claim passed the court and Yogi was found innocent. Huh. But isn't that strange? I thought it said strangle and I was like, very morbid. This letter tells him to get revenge on Edgeworth. Why would he want to take revenge on you? Right.
Yeah?
There's something that's been troubling me these last few days. I didn't know whether or not I should tell you.
You mean the nightmare?
It's a nightmare I've had. A memory of a crime that I committed.
A crime you committed? Worth it.
Remember, worth it.
What?
Worth time. Oh! Yeah!
We're edgy.
Yeah, edgy worth it.
And everyone unsubscribes.
A memory of a murder.
That'd be funny if they just did that, they were just saying that like that.
I think the time has come to tell all.
The nightmare.
For the last 15 years, I've had the same dream almost every night. I wake up in a fearful sweat every time. What kind of dream? It's a dream about my father's killing, in the dark.
Help! I can't breathe!
Quiet, I said. You're not making this any easier.
We just did this!
Don't shout! You want to use some more oxygen! We just did this!
Okay, now we're continuing. I can't breathe! You're using up my air!
What?
Stop breathing my air! I'll stop you!
Ah! What? What are you?
Stop breathing my air!
No! Atticus!
That's you.
No, Atticus. I just said it.
Oh.
He's attacking Atticus! I know, he's a defense attorney. And Scout calls her dad.
Serious moment.
Yeah. Then I see the pistol lying by my feet. I don't know if it was evidence from that day in court or the bailiffs. In a daze, I pick up the pistol. Get away! Get away from my father! And with that scream, I wake. It's a bone-chilling scream. A scream that has rung in my ears for the past 15 years. But...
Oh no!
Maya, why how could you?
You're such a jokester, Edgeworth. Murder.
That's just a dream, right?
Right? Am I right? Okay.
That thought is the only thing that's kept me sane for the last 15 years. But what if I'm wrong? It's funny because Edgeworth never makes jokes.
It's funny because Edgeworth murdered his father. Okay.
What if it's real? They say that sometimes people shut out memories in self-defense. That's actually poopy-hoo.
That's not true.
No, because, what they did is they did an experiment where they did, this Freudian analysis thing where they basically convinced people who had no history of, family abuse, their, father or something had abused them. And they started, and they were like, they're basically just like, you repress the memories, and they actually started remembering things. And so it's just like, well, if you just convince them that they repressed memories, then they'll just believe you, and they'll just start remembering.
Weird. Anyway.
Maybe it was I who killed my father. What?
It doesn't mean that you can't repress memories.
Yeah, that's true. If you think about it this way, this letter makes sense. But I mean, telling someone they repress their memories. Get your revenge on Miles Edgeworth. Think about it. Yogi was really innocent. That's why he wanted revenge against me.
Wait, Edgeworth. You mean...
It was me. I was the true criminal of Deal 6. I shot my father.
This is bad.
What are we going to do, Nick? What can we do?
I don't know. His jokes aren't that funny anymore. I don't think there's anything we can do except bring him to a comedy club or something. If there's someone else who knows a lot about the DL6 incident, maybe.
There is, Nick. There is someone else who knows about the DL6 incident.
And we'll go see him in the next part.
All right.
Please subscribe, comment, question in the description.
Later.
See you guys next time.